In the shadowy depths of the ocean, two colossal ships rest in eternal slumber, Titanic and Bismarck. The Titanic, once the epitome of luxury and grandeur, the Bismarck, a formidable symbol of wartime power. Yet, as years have passed, the destinies of these two iconic vessels have diverged dramatically. The Titanic has decayed into a crumbling shell, while the Bismarck remains astonishingly well-preserved. Today, we dive into this maritime mystery. We will explore why the Titanic disintegrated and why the Bismarck has stood the test of time. But before we embark on this journey, let's take a closer look at the history of these two legendary ships. Launched in 1912, the Titanic was the largest and most luxurious ship ever built at the time. With its opulent cabins, grand ballrooms, and even a swimming pool, it represented the pinnacle of transatlantic travel. But on April 15, 1912, fate struck. The Titanic collided with an iceberg, broke into and sank into the icy waters. The wreck of the Titanic was not discovered until 1985. Since then, researchers have conducted numerous dives to study the ship and its fragments. However, over time, the condition of the Titanic has rapidly deteriorated. Its metal hull has started to rust, wooden furnishings have decayed, and even the decks have begun to collapse. Experts are certain that by 2050, the Titanic will have completely disintegrated. The Bismarck was one of the most powerful warships constructed by Nazi Germany during World War II. With its heavy armor and formidable weapons, it posed a daunting threat to enemy ships. However, in 1941, the Bismarck was cornered by the British Navy and met its end in an epic naval battle. The wreckage of the Bismarck was not discovered until 1989. Since then, researchers have conducted numerous dives to study the ship and its fragments. Surprisingly, the Bismarck is in much better preserved condition compared to the Titanic. Its metal hull remains sturdy, wooden decks are still relatively intact, and some of its weapons are even ready to fire. There are many reasons for this difference between the two shipwrecks. One of the significant factors that contributed to the difference between them was the materials used in the construction of the ships. This, of course, is closely related to the intended purposes of the ships. The Bismarck was designed and built as a formidable warship intended to withstand intense artillery fire. It was constructed from Krupp steel, a material far superior to the softer steel used in the Titanic, specially hardened for the purpose. Furthermore, the Bismarck's hull was welded rather than riveted, providing a sturdier and more resilient structure capable of withstanding the immense pressure of the deep ocean. In contrast, the Titanic, designed for luxury and speed, was not constructed to withstand such harsh conditions. Its construction, focused on aesthetics and passenger comfort, did not prioritize the same level of durability as a warship like the Bismarck. Additionally, the Titanic used significantly more wood compared to the Bismarck. Wood is an organic material that rapidly decays in water. Therefore, the wooden decks and furnishings of the Titanic deteriorated much faster than those of the Bismarck. When compared to the Titanic, which boasted expansive, lavish wooden panels in its first-class cabins, the Bismarck, built for warfare, had fewer large open spaces and much thicker armored surfaces. This advantage played a significant role in the Bismarck's durability. By the way, we must not underestimate the power of paint. The Bismarck likely benefited from more advanced and thicker protective paint compared to the Titanic. This additional defense layer helped shield the Bismarck's hull from the corrosive effects of salt water. The paint designed for aesthetic appeal rather than maximum durability on the Titanic did not provide the same level of protection, contributing to its faster decay. And one of the most significant factors is the difference in the sinking conditions of the ships. The Titanic, with its hull split in two upon hitting an iceberg, fragmented as it descended to the ocean floor. This catastrophic breakage exposed a much larger surface area to corrosive forces, accelerating the decay process. Conversely cornered by the British Navy, the Bismarck sank in an epic naval battle, with its hull remaining relatively intact as it reached the ocean floor in one piece. This disparity in sinking scenarios directly impacted the resilience of the wreckage. The fractured hull of the Titanic was more susceptible to decay and corrosion compared to the more intact structure of the Bismarck, which minimized the exposed surface area, enhancing its resistance against deterioration. We've come to the most important and final factor. Almost everything we've discussed so far could be considered secondary causes. But now let's talk about the most crucial factor that determines the difference between the wreckage of the two ships, the depth. Depending on where they sank, the Titanic lies at a depth of 3,800 meters, while the Bismarck rests at 4,800 meters. This 1,000-meter difference in depth, along with the associated 10-degree difference in temperature, is a critical factor, contributing to the faster decay of the Titanic's wreckage. In shallower waters, the wreckage of the Titanic provides a warmer and more hospitable environment for decaying organisms, including metal-eating bacteria. These bacteria, thriving in the presence of oxygen and nutrients, corrode metals. The primary factor rapidly deteriorating the Titanic's hull is, in fact, these bacteria. In contrast, the Bismarck, located in deeper and colder waters compared to the Titanic, experiences less impact from these bacteria due to oxygen depletion. Cold water significantly slows bacterial activity, while oxygen deficiency leads to a scarcity of food sources. This contributes to better preservation of the Bismarck's wreckage compared to the Titanic's. Another crucial factor to consider is the salinity of the water where the ships rest.
The Titanic, lying in the North Atlantic Ocean, is subjected to higher salinity levels, which accelerates the corrosion of its metal components. The presence of salt in the water facilitates electrochemical reactions that degrade metal structures more rapidly.
In contrast, the Bismarck's resting place in the North Atlantic, though also saline, is slightly less corrosive due to the colder temperatures at greater depths, further aiding in its preservation. In summary, the contrasting fates of the Titanic and the Bismarck can be attributed to a combination of factors, including construction materials, environmental conditions, and the circumstances of their sinking. The Titanic's luxurious yet less durable design, coupled with its unfortunate breakup and more hospitable resting environment for corrosive forces, has led to its accelerated decay. Meanwhile, the Bismarck's robust construction, deeper and colder resting place, and more intact sinking have contributed to its remarkable preservation.
These contrasting fates remind us of the immense power of the ocean environment. Even the mightiest vessels can be humbled by the relentless forces of corrosion and decay. Yet, the wrecks of the Titanic and Bismarck continue to hold a place of fascination, serving as silent monuments to the ingenuity and tragedy of human history. As technology advances, researchers will undoubtedly continue to delve deeper into these wrecks, uncovering new secrets about their final journeys and the enduring power of the ocean depths. The final resting places of the Titanic and Bismarck may be worlds apart, but they share a common story, a testament to the enduring power of the ocean and the fragility of human ambitions.